you ask me to put those boxes in?
Well, you'll see later, because they are probably the four most important conclusions that you will come to as you investigate a very important concept in science: why something floats or sinks.
Oh, okay.
And that's what we're doing with this scale and my clay boat that I showed you.
Okay.
And you've already weighed it, right?
Mm-hmm.
What did it weigh?
It weighed 140 grams.
Okay, notice that's the first important piece of data. That's why you're putting it in the box.
Okay.
Okay. Now the next thing is what?
That's the water level.
Okay, check the water level here in this pitcher.
It's about 600 milliliters.
Okay. Notice that I have had you put it down in grams, however.
Yeah.
So put 600 down, because as you know, 1 milliliter of water weighs 1 gram.
Right.
So we can read this in grams as well as milliliters.
Right.
Or cc's. Okay. Okay. Then what's the next one?
Float level.
I'm going to float the boat mm-hmm. in the water. Should the water go up, down, or stay the same?
It should go up.
Okay. Oop, I got just a little water in the boat. Okay, what's the water level read now?
It's just under 750.
Okay, if you don't mind, would you agree that it's 740?
Yeah.
Okay, you'll see why in a moment. Now what does it say is the next thing you have to do? Difference.
Difference.
Subtract.
That's 140 grams.
See the there. Two boxes?
Oh, they're both the same.
Yes. Now you can see that something floats when it displaces this amount of water that's equal to its weight.
Oh,
and
I see.
It happens to be weight of water, but you can also see it's also the volume of water, right?
Right.
Right. Okay, now we're going to sink the boat. And to do that, I'm going to form it into a ball,
okay.
like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to put it in the water.
Okay.
Should the water go up, down, and stay the same? It's not floating anymore now.
It should still go up.
Okay. Now I can raise this to make sure it's all underwater and not touching the sides.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What's the water level with the ball in it?
About 700 milliliters.
Okay, put
or
that
700
down.
700 grams.
You know the water level from up here.
Yep, that's
600. You can put
600.
That down. Subtract.
Now the difference is 100.
Okay. Now, what is the next thing we need?
The weight in the air,
okay,
and that's
you know what that
140
is,
grams.
And the last thing?
The weight in water.
So now you have to re-weigh it. I'll zero the scale, and just to save time, start with the back one.
Okay.
Almost?
Yep.
Are you sure it's not touching? Okay, what does it read?
40.
40, so put that down. You see what you have to do next?
The difference,
yeah.
And that's 100 grams.
And the boxes?
Hey, they're the same again.
Yes. In other words, think about it this way. When something is in water, you know that it's going to weigh less because you know there's a buoyant effect in water.
Uh-huh.
Even though it sinks, it's still buoyed up by the amount of water it displaces.
I see.
Only this time we did it in grams instead of cc's or milliliters.
I see.
Okay.
So if something weighs 140 grams, it should displace the same amount of water that it weighs
if
so it that
floats.
It floats.
Right. Okay. And if it sinks?
It should still
being
displace.
Still
amount.
Being buoyed up by the amount of water
right.
it displaces. Well, you got the idea. And you did a beautiful job with the chart. Congratulations.
Thanks.